But let's just return now to our big focus this evening, the decision of the Army Chief, General V.K. Singh, to go to court. This is after the government rejected his age, or the age of birth that he feels is the accurate age of birth. Joining us now to discuss this and to discuss really whether this entire controversy has hurt the image of the armed forces, the image of the army specifically. Rear Admiral Raja Menon, former Vice Chief of Navy Staff, also joining us. General Shankar Prasad, Ajay Shukla, familiar face on NDTV as well. And also Puneet Bali, the advocate for General V.K. Singh, joins us from Chandigarh. Thank you all very much for being with us. General Prasad, if I can come to you first. If you're a 21-year-old tank commander or a 21-year-old fighter pilot watching this, wouldn't you also perhaps believe, what kind of force am I in where the top man is trying to do, or seemingly trying to do, everything possible to hang on to his seat?
I agree with your question totally. But first of all, let me make my own personal position very clear. I do not wish to politicize the matter. It has been politicized adequately over the last 6 months. Nor do I wish to be politically correct or politically aggressive today. I wish to place before the viewers today the true perception, the true understanding of each and every one of us who has been in the uniform for 40 years plus. Let me tell you that while General V.K. Singh, the Chief of the Army Staff, may be legally correct, and perhaps he is legally correct, he has got adequate evidence to prove that he is born in 1951 and therefore has chosen to go to the court, and perhaps if the court, the Supreme Court, admits his writ petition and accepts that the evidence proves that he is 1951 born, he may get a decision in his favor. Having said that, let me tell you and answer the question that you raised. Each one of us has been brought up in the armed forces, Army, Navy and the Air Force, to obey orders. And it is considered a poor manner of behavior if we question orders. If we begin to question orders from young age, where is this armed forces going to go? We have a primary issue to say service before self. And somebody has changed it. The India Today cover says self before service. How do you feel? You feel terribly hurt. You feel terribly hurt while in uniform. You, I'm quite sure, feel terribly hurt when you're outside the uniform. The day you enter the Pashan gate of the National Defense Academy, the first thing that you're told is service before self. And suddenly, as a flight lieutenant or a captain or a major, whatever rank you may be wearing in the armed forces, you find India Today saying self before service. Each one of us terribly hurt. Doesn't matter who's right, doesn't matter who's wrong, doesn't matter what politically is correct, doesn't matter what legally is correct. The Chief of the Army Staff sits in a temple. The Chief of Services sit in a temple. We all look at that office in great awe. And everybody who looks at service chiefs with great awe. I don't know what the young officers today would be thinking.
Okay, so I'm going to come back to you in a moment because I want to bring in Puneet Bali, the advocate for General V.K. Singh. Mr. Bali, I'm sure the documents you have, the papers you have, and the case you have before you would be immaculately prepared. You've thought about this for months, and now you've decided to file a writ petition. But you are representing a man, no matter how serious, senior, who has questioned a basic fundamental issue. And that issue is orders. Everybody follows orders. A soldier on the field follows an order from a senior officer. The Chief of Army Staff has to follow orders from the government. That's what the Constitution says. Why do you believe there is merit in what General Singh is doing, other than strictly a legal document-based perspective?
See, I must tell you this once, that the petition has been filed and the matter is sub judice before the court. So I, as a counsel, would not say anything more than that. I would only say that it is filed on a conviction that once in all army records, the date of birth is recorded as 10th of May 1951. And all promotions, all medals, everything, all decorations are based on 10th of May 1951, then it also becomes a matter of pride, honor and dignity that a man of such high rank, can you say that he is not effectively or rightly telling his date of birth once it is recorded in all documents? As far as the merit of the case are concerned, since the matter is sub judice, it is before the court, I can only tell you one thing. This is a fight for dignity and honor.
NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone, fastest scorecard, special analysis and much more. Download free, ndtv.com/apps.